invite your attention to the insert as well. We are 2 weeks away from April 2nd, which I know with your carabiners and all of the information that you have been given, that you know that that date is the day of our ingathering for our capital campaign. And we are excited that we are getting that close to it. So you can read here on the front of the insert where we've been. You may not realize that this has been actually in concept for 7 years and been actually aggressively worked upon for the last 5 years before I even arrived here at St. James. So you can see where we've been, where we are currently in the project, and when we're going to break ground and what our future holds. And as you pray over what commitment you might be able to make to the project, all those questions you might have hopefully are answered with the back part of that page with our frequently asked questions section. And now I'd love for Chris Giglio to come and talk about how he and Benet, his wife, made their decision about committing to the project. So thank you, Chris, very much.
Good morning. You know, I've been coming here 17 years, and I've never seen anyone drink out of this glass of water that the Altar Guild ladies, the lovely Altar Guild ladies, always put here. So, thank you.
It's 17 years old.
Yeah. We have good water. So, as I said, it's been 17 years since I first walked through these doors. And it was here, in this church, right here, I was 33 years old when I first walked in here, 17 years ago. In that time, I've been confirmed here. I've seen two of my sons baptized and confirmed here. And I've been married here. Now I came here, when I came through these doors, I didn't come through here because I was an Episcopalian. I didn't come through here because I had friends who were parishioners. I came here, and many of you know this already. I spoke about this a few years ago at the behest of Dr. Dart. I walked through these doors because my younger son, we had just enrolled him at the St. James Preschool. So like many others here, it was the school, our school, which is now St. James Episcopal School, that brought my family through these doors. Now, it's been all of you, my fellow parishioners, who have kept me and my family walking through the doors. It's here in this place, and I paraphrase Matthew 18, that you and I gather together in Jesus' name, and he is in our midst. So as I said right here, I took my vows, confirmed all these things. And I'm not alone. Many of you have had significant life events happen here. What's extremely significant is what happens on most regular Sundays. Most Sundays, I share the Lord's table here with you. We gather together in his name, and he is in our midst. So suffice to say, St. James has been important to me. And like I said, I trust it's been important to you. I don't stand here today to convince you of the value of this place or this parish or this congregation. I hope that's been revealed to you already. What I want to talk to you about is something that's very uncomfortable for most of us to talk about. Money. I know you're surprised, considering the lead-up we had. As you know, our goal here at St. James is to raise over $2.2 million for our Connected campaign. I think it's safe to say that's a significant amount, and it's surely a stretch for a small community. Connected is one of the themes today, and my main theme here is stretch. Allow me to briefly tell you my stretch story. Last summer, I drove down to and back from South Carolina for the YMO trip with Father Ben as my traveling partner. We whiled away the long drive as we talked and caught up. On the way home, we reminisced about the week, our experiences, the trip's characters, both young and not so young. And we talked a little bit about the tail whipping he gave me every morning during our morning run as I watched him run away from me. Eventually, we picked up a topic that we had briefly started but were sidetracked from during the drive down, the impending Connected campaign project. Father Ben offered to fill me in on the project since he knew that I was interested in having been involved with the project even before his arrival. As he mentioned to you just now, it's been going on quite some time. He related to me that they had set up the apparatus for fundraising and described the process. Our past time working together on the church budget had, I believe, made us comfortable talking about money, and we did so frankly. Father Ben shared with me about his family's commitment, his own family's financial commitment, and how it fit in with what was being asked of those central to the effort. Now, I'm not going to share with you what he shared with me, nor with exactly what I share with him. Not numbers, anyways. I lost my spot here. But what Father Ben did do is he admitted to me that he was stretching his comfort zone for a cause and a mission he truly valued, for St. James's Parish, which we both believe, and I think you believe, is our church and our school inextricably connected. When he rattled off some numbers, I was kind of dumbstruck. I mentioned that I had not yet given much thought to my pledge, but my initial inkling was that any capital campaign pledge I would at least offset any increase to my yearly operational pledge and perhaps reduce it. Mind you, I said this offhand and without, and here's the key, without any real discernment. I hadn't thought in terms of stretch. He assured me the kickoff was at least a few months away. Whew. So there and then I realized I hadn't really given the subject the discernment it deserved, considering how important I professed it was to me. And I did, just like I told you here today. This place was important to me. I told myself that it was important to me. Yet I hadn't really given it the due diligence that it was due. So we soon arrived home, and I continued to consider and pray about our conversation. It stayed on my mind, and it stayed in my heart. In time, I realized my initial off-the-cuff calculations were perfectly acceptable, and they were perfectly safe, and they were comfortable. Yet Father Ben's honest, frank, and unassuming testimony stuck with me. I started to think, well, could I stretch my budget explorations and give significantly, or even insignificantly, beyond my comfort zone? What is important for me to relate to you today is not the specifics of my budgeting prowess, nor my family's idea of or level of generosity, but rather the concept that I initially hadn't even stepped into that place, hadn't stretched. I hadn't stepped into that thin place we often hear Father Ben talk about. To look. Until Father Ben had relayed to me what was, as I said, an uncomfortable number, stepping into that thin place was never on my radar screen. So I got my aviation reference in here, radar screen. But our conversation had, without solicitation and without plea, convicted me to look at things from a different and heretofore uncomfortable vantage point. I know Father Ben's intellect too well to completely write off his remarks as unwitting, but I do believe that they were without guile. So, at home, I had a conversation with Benet. I had already done a little homework and a little praying on my own, but we discussed together how this project was important to the church, to the school, to the parish, and to us. Of course, we discussed how the music program was surely to benefit, and how much that particular ministry had given to us. I truly believe it was in no small part responsible for our very marriage. We explored it together and determined we could contribute far more over 3 years than I would have initially thought possible. We could indeed stretch. Now, realize far more is a relative term, and rightly so. Recall Mark's gospel verse about the poor widow who put 2 small copper coins into the temple treasury. 2 coins was more than a stretch for her. So I needn't tell you what a stretch is for me, nor need I ask you what a stretch would be for you. I am merely compelled by the Holy Spirit and by Father Ben, because he asked me to come, to genuinely ask you to think and pray about what it is to you, what is a stretch to you, and to prayerfully and deeply consider if you can stretch. Perhaps you didn't think you could or would give to the Connected campaign. In that case, maybe a stretch is 2 coins. Maybe it's $2. Maybe it's $200. Perhaps you've already come to a quick conclusion, such as I had. In that case, I ask that you pray and discern a little bit more in the next 2 weeks. Perhaps you are less impetuous and more prepared than I, and you've already given considerable prayer and discernment to the issue. In that case, I admire you, but I also ask that in these last 2 weeks, perhaps you can pray and discern a little more. No matter which case you fall in, I pray that you will consider stretching out of your comfort zone, whether a lot or a little. The amount may not matter too much in the scheme of a $2.2 million capital campaign, but it may make a difference in your life, in your relationship with finances, with your parish, with God, with your relationship around all those things. I know it has in mine, and it has in my family's. So I thank you today, and I look forward to seeing you April 2nd.